I went to the mirror. Then a shiver suddenly ran down my spine. I got spooked and left. You didn't even go through with it? And you call yourself an occultist? What's wrong with you? Come on! Grow a backbone, girl! You're supposed to have a bigger... This girl has bigger balls than I do. I would never go into an abandoned school. But she wussed out at the last second, like I would do. You're on my level now, bitch! Greetings, my beautiful viewers. I am the Hunter of Comedy, and welcome to a brand new game called Death Mark. So, I have no idea what this game is about. I literally saw it in the store, saw it was a horror game, and it's been, it was licensed and published by Axis Games. Axis Games have published some of my favorite games, and they were actually the ones who published, the final game in the Nonary game series. They published Zero Time Dilemma after it was, like, it was at first canceled, and then uncanceled, and then in hiatus, and then it finally got released, and as we all know, I played it. It was awesome. And so they brought us another horror game. Again, I know little to nothing of what this is about, but I'm excited to find out, so let's start a new game. Ooh. The art style is nice. Hey, wanna hit up the karaoke place? The new Love and Hero song is out. I'm not feeling up to it today. This story creeped me out earlier. Wait, are they talking? It seems super quiet. They may be talking. Okay, no, like, I'm hearing voices in the background, but it's not what they're saying. Okay. This story creeped me out earlier. Do you want to hear it? Sure? What story is this? You remember Miss Yamaguchi? She wears those big glasses? It's kind of mean. I heard she's gone missing? What? No one knows where she is? Nope, she just disappeared. She's up and pooped from the library. Ooh. One of the Sorry, that was really a little too loud in my headphones. I had to adjust them a bit, but, okay. Here we go. One of the student librarians said she was researching something there. But then, she vanished. But she's super diligent, right? One of the students thought it was weird that she'd up and leave like that. So he checked in on her. But when he did... Oh! Only thing left was her arm! Oh my god! Like, what the fuck? I mean, we just started! I did not expect it to get started, like, so quickly! I should have! It's a horror game! It had her really weird scar on it, so it was definitely her arm. A scar? Yeah, it looked like a dog bite. She showed it to me once. She had no idea where it came from. Okay, that's probably the death mark thing that the game is named for. For real? There was a scar like that on Miki's leg, too. What? I don't know who Miki is, but, you know. Huh? Miki? Oh, wait, that's... The girl who went missing, yeah. Oh, wow, I mean, like, they're talking about a lot of people going missing. That's crazy. Maybe that rumor is true. What about the cursed scar? Oh, cut it out. You're scaring me. Oh. Oh. Well, there's someone else. I heard snatches of an idiotic ghost story. They're speaking seriously, but it's obvious they don't believe a word. They're only killing time. Rumors are the best way to do that. Sun's about to set. It's gotten later than I planned. I shouldn't have stuck around to hear that story. I better hurry. Well, who are you? Oh! What's going on? Okay. I mean, it's not okay. Ellipsis. Thunder rumbles in the distance. A huge mansion is in front of me. Strange. I'm sure I was just... My vision blurs. My ears are buzzing. I don't even know who I am. Ugh, my head's swimming. It's almost like I'm drunk. Ugh, maybe I am drunk. Maybe this whole game is just a fever-drunk dream. That would be fantastic, except with all the death. That is not good. What time is it? I glance at my wrist, but my watch is gone. Did I put it in my coat pocket? All I find is a business card. In elegant printed letters is a name. Saya Kujo, Spirit Healer. Spirit Healer. On the back is a photo of the mansion. I guess this must be the Kujo Mansion, then. Kujo Mansion, Saya Kujo. Those names sound familiar somehow. One way to find out. Taking a deep breath, I reach out to knock. I stop when I see something on my wrist. Something? Oh, that's apparently the death mark. You can see by all the death hands behind it. It does... I mean, yeah, it does kind of look like teeth marks, but it also... I mean, like, at least to me, it kind of looks like, kind of like wings on the end. I'm not really sure. A strange scar. When did that... I could just be imagining this, but... I feel an icy chill when I look at it. I mean, like, all the death behind it? Yeah, if you see that too, I'm pretty sure that's the reason. I'm knocking fiercely, okay? My fist pounds on the door. No reply. Oh, a light appears in the second floor window. Probably too far from the door for them to hear me knocking. I grasp the doorknob and find it unlocked. No point in staying outside. I mean, except for you're intruding into someone else's home. I mean, I don't normally do that. I mean, like, I may peek my head in and say hello, but I mean, like, completely going inside? That's kind of rude, whatever your name is. They have not introduced the character I am playing as. He seems like a tall, like, you know, guy in a jacket from that last picture we saw, but that's about it. That's all I've got to go on. I know nothing else about him. I'll just go in. I'll apologize to the owner later. Okay, at least he's making the effort to be, you know, like, hey, yeah, I'll just apologize later for being, like, super rude. Wow, it is super dark. The inside is shrouded in darkness. A small beam of light from the window is the only way I can see anything in here. It's dead silent except for the constant ticking of clocks, of a clock second hand. I must be in the entrance hall. The atrium extends to the second floor. Anyone home? There is no reply to my shout. Yeah, maybe they've soundproofed this place so they can't hear me down here. Why would they do that? What gives you any intention that they would do that? I guess I need to go upstairs then. The staircase is just visible up ahead. I walk toward it, cutting across the hall. Oh, my ears catch a strange noise. I heard that strange noise too. I turn to look where it's coming from. Well, someone's there, enveloped by the dark. I think they're staring at me. It looks like a creepy doll is what it looks like. Ah, first choice of the game. Talk to them. I don't feel as good to ignore that. Hello? I call out, but the person remains silent. Approach them. Gulping, I hesitantly make my way over. Trepidation, slowing my steps. It's a young girl. She doesn't move an inch as I approach. At least it seems that way to me. It doesn't look like she's even breathing. A corpse? Or it could be a doll. It looks like a freaking doll to me. But it's gonna open its eyes. I swear to God, it's gonna open its eyes. Great, I creeped myself out. I started to sweat. What should I do? Back away! I carefully began climbing the stairs, making sure not to trip. Okay. I mean, should I have touched her? I felt the safer thing to do would be to go away from her. Oh, I need to make bad decisions. I kind of wish I could go back and redo that, but I'm not going to go back now. As I reach the landing, the sharp sound of a bell breaks the silence. It seems to be coming from above me. It's a clock. We established this already. Looking up, I can spy the outline of a clock. I know, you said this already. I bet that's what's making the sound. Yep. But let's just wait for it to be done. I pause and wait for the clamor to end. Doesn't seem to be stopping. Maybe it's broken. Let's approach it. The noise guides me over. It's an antique grandfather clock. The noise is definitely coming from here. I reach toward the glass to check inside. Oh. All of a sudden it stops chiming. Oh, good. Silence descends, broken only by the ticking. I mean, I guess it's fixed now, but that timing was a little too spot on. Was it really a coincidence? All these strange occurrences make me uneasy, but I continue on to the room with the light. Stopping in front of the door, I knock. Knock, knock, knock. But again, there's no reply. I try again several times, even calling out. Hello? Someone in there? I have the weird mark on my arm. Does this mean I'm dead? Or death is coming? Or that I'm going to be eaten by dogs? I mean, this should be explained. No, but there's still no answer. I push on the door. There is no light. Huh. It's dark inside. Strange. You know, I definitely saw lights on in here when I was outside. There's blood on the ground. Wafting through the room is an odd smell. It's a sugary, like a ripe fruit. Why? The whole room is permeated with it. It's blood. Some kind of aromatherapy, maybe? It's not a particularly pleasant smell, though. The aroma draws me further into the room. Floor under my feet feels off, because you're stepping on blood. It's wet. How can you not figure this shit out? It dawns on me that I'm smelling something else mixed in with the sweet smell. I know this scent, this metallic tang. Lightning flashes and I catch a glimpse of something. Startling grotesque object stretches out across the floor beneath my feet. Something strange is there. Stare at it! That's a dead body! It's so bizarre that I can't stop staring. That is a dead body. Blooming flowers are everywhere. Are they actually blooming out of her chest? Or, I mean, I don't know anymore. That's creepy. They're bursting out of the woman's stomach. Her blood-soaked body overwhelmed with them. Wrench my gaze away, horrified. hellish images burn into my mind. I can feel my entire body shaking. Bile rises. I'm gonna throw up. Oh, there's a little ghost. Oh no, I'm not okay with this. Oh no. In the next instant, the lights are on, and there's still blood on the ground, and the fuck? And the fuck? Oh, wait, that's not all. The body is gone, leaving only a stain. Hold on one second here. Okay, there is that. I don't have anything else. I can put that away. Okay, never mind. Hold on one second. It's a bad dream, at least. I'd really much prefer if it was. Oh, shoot. No. I did not mean to skip that. Hold on. I'm trying to find a way to just make the, bar at the bottom go away so we can get a better image of things. Hold on. Okay. I'm just gonna read this. But the faint smell that remains and the bloodstained crush, any hope I had of that, yeah. I beat a retreat from the room in an effort to escape this bizarre, situation. And now all the lights are on. When I stumble back into the hall, the lights are on in here as well. I decide to have another look around. All the furniture here is old enough to be antiques. They match this old-fashioned mansion. A large doll sits on the couch. Yep, I told you it was a doll. This must be the figure I saw in the dark. One would easily mistake it for a human if they, couldn't see the ballpoints. Yeah. Probably belongs to the owner of the house. Mansion. Whatever. So what do I do now? Contact the police? Maybe? Her stomach was full of flowers, sir, and the corpse up and vanished like fog. I'm totally not cray-cray. Yeah, like anyone would believe that. I'm totally cray-cray.
ようこそ.
Welcome to the Kazuo Mansion. I'm guessing it's the doll that's talking. Yep, the doll blinked. The doll moved. It spoke. A different kind of shudder runs through me than the one when I found the corpse. Up until this point, I was nothing more than an observer to all these freaky events. I could distance myself from it, but now, a doll is talking to me!
Have I startled you? If so, I sincerely apologize. My master ordered me to behave as a normal doll until told otherwise.
The words are elegant and refined, but her face never moves an inch. She may look human, but she clearly isn't. She slowly folds her hands together, so she can move too.
I am sorry for not introducing myself. I am called Mary.
Hello, Mary. How are you this evening? You likely have a number of oddities. You've likely seen a number of oddities here already. A couple. Little ghost girl. A dead girl blooming flowers out of her stomach. I mean, like, just another day in the business. I don't know what... I know nothing about this character. I literally know nothing about this character that I am. I know nothing, and no one has told me anything other than I have this... The game is called Death Mark. I have a mark on my arm that is probably the Death Mark, and a doll is talking to me. This is how much information I currently have about this game. It's not much, but, it's there.
I see. My master, Saya Kazuo, was unable to escape from the mark then.
What? What? Okay, wait, hold on. Saya Kazuo was unable to escape from the mark? What does that mean? Did she... Why am I here? I don't get what's going on, man.
Saya Kazuo, does that mean that corpse?
Oh, that corpse was Saya Kazuo then. I guess. I mean, I honestly don't know at this point. Like, I am getting super invested in this game, but I'm also super confused, too. But wait, what's this about a mark? Lady Saya was searching for a way to escape the mark. Were you not also called here by her because of the mark on your arm? Is that what happened? She must be talking about this weird scar. Did Sai Kujo invite me to this mansion? When I try to remember, my head hurts. I have something to tell you in place of my late master. But I would like to ask one thing first. Do you know your own name? That was a much simpler question than I had been expecting. It's... Yeah, I don't remember my name, do I? I break out into a sweat. My throat is drying up. Why? Why can't I answer? I'm shocked to find I'm coming up blank.
I see. Then it is as I thought.
Somehow Mary knows what's going on with me.
Before I offer an explanation, please decide on a temporary name. Things will go much easier if I have a name by which to call you. It is also likely you will find it hard to remain calm if you're nameless.
And I'm guessing I get to name myself. She's probably right. Better to have some placeholder name than continue life as a hollow, lifeless being. Oh, that's oddly specific! I mean, I have lots of names I'd rather be called, but, you know, sure. Enter the protagonist's name. Up to 10 letters. Yashiki? That's what they give me. I was gonna say, if it left it completely up to me, I would have gone with, like, the default that I usually use, which is Hunter. But I like Yashiki. Yashiki. Yashiki sounds cool. Sure. I'll be Yashiki. Oh, that was just his last name. Kazuo Yashiki? I'm not upset with this. Kazuo Yashiki, sure. It cannot be changed after this. Okay, sure, why not? Oh, I'm customizing my appearance. Glasses and beard, beard, glasses, or none. I think the glasses and the beard look good. I mean, plain no, just glasses is fine. Beard, plain no. I like glasses and beard. Okay, is this important? I don't know if this is going to be important later. Sure, why not? I like the glasses and beard look, actually. I'm Kazuo Yashiki. Understood, Lord Yashiki. Now I shall explain to you about the mark. It is the seal of death. Oh, joy. Those who have it will soon die. That sucks. I mean, not that I hadn't figured that out already. You do not believe me? I'm certain this sounds absurd to one who has led an uneventful life. However, my master's death proves it to be irrefutably true. Did she have the mark? I didn't see the mark. Corpse's sweet stench comes back to me. That didn't seem like the work of humans. I'm afraid that the horror of the mark does not stop there. It doesn't stop at death. Victims slowly lose their memories until the day they die. They face death all the while suffering from the terror of losing oneself. Memory loss. Well, that can't be. That'd mean that I'm... Yes. The fact that you have forgotten your name proves that death is coming. Oh, joy! Lord Yashiki, you... I what? will die this very dawn. Death mark. Okay. Roll credits, I guess. My memory skipped forward a bit after that. I just remember being completely stunned at what Mary revealed to me. I can probably attribute it to memory loss caused by the mark. Next thing I know, I'm lying in a guest room in the mansion. I vaguely recall dragging myself up the stairs and coming here. I must have fallen asleep at some point, and thanks to that, I feel a lot better. I'll die at dawn, huh? I try saying it out loud. It's definitely shocking, but I can't say it feels real yet. It doesn't make sense, way out of the blue. But if it's true, he's waiting for my untimely death, the only thing I can do? Might be a good idea to ask Mary more about it. May as well. That's abrupt piano music. I mean, not that I dislike it. I find Mary sitting in the exact same spot as before. She hasn't moved an inch. She's a doll. I'm not exactly upset about that, but at the same time, were you expecting her to move? I doubt a doll gets bored waiting like humans do. Good morning, Lord Yashiki. Are you feeling better now? I feel terrible. That is only natural, of course. Since it appears that you have calmed down, I would like to ask a question. Oh god, another! What will you do now? I can guide you down only two paths? First is to wait for death. Okay, that's not a fan of that plan. Second is to fight the mark. I will bank on that. We'll try that. Can you help me? If that is what you wish, yes. My master was researching the mark. A few days prior to her death, she found a way to escape it. She did? Then how did it get her? Regretfully, she passed away before she was able to inform me. Wait, then how do you know she did find a way to beat it? Because obviously she didn't. So she doesn't know anything after all. There is some time yet before dawn. You have a slim chance. Salvation is a thin thread dangling from heaven. Yes, it is. Would that you would grab hold of it, and I shall do my utmost to help. What will you do? Guess it boils down to whether I trust her. Now, if she's right about all this, my time on Earth is up at dawn. If I don't want to die, then there's no other choice but to resist the mark until then. If she's lying, I'll be fine when morning comes. But am I really all right with that? Ugh! Oh, people are being killed in nonsensical, grotesque ways. Am I going to turn a blind eye to it? I mean, I don't know why I would or would not. I know nothing about this man. This is a life or death decision. I need to think about it carefully. Live or die? Deadly choice. You will be faced with choices that can result in death. Okay. There's limited time, and your soul power will continue to drain. Time's up or wrong answers will result in game over. Okay, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get a lot of those. So be quick and be careful to find careful in finding the right answer. Restoring soul power. Completing a daily choice will restore some soul power. Accelerated dialogue. Dialogue will be sped up when you press the L button. But certain dialogue cannot be sped up. Backlog. Yeah, I can look at the backlog, I know that. Auto mode. Just text will go on. Hiding the dialogue window. Pressing the X button. Okay, that would have been nice to know earlier. Okay, yeah, there we go. I can toggle it now. Okay. Then I shall ask you. Will you quietly wait for death or struggle against the mark? I'm gonna quietly wait for death, first off. Just because I want to see what's gonna happen. I'm gonna wait for death. Wrong! Then you meekly accept your death by the mark. Accept death. I'm just gonna accept death! I've already gotten this far. Oh, wrong choice! Oh, I see, so it just uses it up. I see, so you get multiple choices. Is that so? Then please rest here in the mansion until dawn.
おやすみなさいませ.
Good night. Oh. Game over. Okay, I mean, I guess it's just game over then. Oh! Yeah, let's just decide again. Well, it gives me this choice instantly, though. Live or die! Oh, okay, we've seen all this. Alright, here we go. We're gonna make the better choice this time. Let's fight the mark. Safe! I like being safe. Safe is nice. Safe is great. Survived! What did I survive? Like, I survived my own stupidity. That's what it did. I've decided to trust you. As you say, Lord Yashiki, then I shall carry out the dying wish of my master and aid you. I cannot do much, but feel free to request anything you wish of me. I don't mean any offense. What can you do for me? I don't even know you. I made up my mind, but that doesn't mean I know what I should do. This is a very good point. I know squat about the supernatural. And losing my memory makes research impossible. But I don't have a moment to lose. A knock comes from the front door. More people! Who come here this late at night? Oh my, what a sign of fate. It seems that other mark bearers have arrived. Oh, okay, good, because I was worried the whole game was just going to be me and her and just like death traps or something. But I mean, like, if other people are involved, this is definitely going to make the game a lot more interesting. Is it instinct that she knows these things? Maybe she has some kind of mysterious power, being a talking doll and all. I beg your pardon, Lord Yashiki. I do apologize, but could you go greet our guests in my stead? They may experience shock if a doll such as myself welcomes them. Yeah, but I'm pretty sure that I can explain things away, but either way, it's fine. Moreover, while I'm able to move my arms, I am unable to walk! I'm gonna have to carry you places with me, aren't I? I got to, like, piggyback her everywhere, trying to figure shit out. Move to the front door and greet our guests. People fated to die, just like me. I wonder what they're like. Who I find at the door is not who I'd expected to see this late at night. A high schooler. She looks really fucking creepy, too. Like, God, those eyes are just so fucking creepy. And she has a yen coin around her neck, which is, maybe it's a talisman, I don't know. And a small boy who seems ultra creepy. Both of them are creepy as fuck. These kids have the mark? No way. We came to see Professor Kujo? Who are you? Can't say I'm a total stranger since I'm here in the manor. I'm her boyfriend, a relative. I'm her disciple. I like that. Okay. She's got so much spiritual power. So surprised she'd have disciples. Oh, good. That was a good choice. Good job, me. Self high five. That was just a clap, but still it works. She seems to know Saya Kujo. Now that I think about it, that business card did say Spirit Healer. Going off this girl's accessories, I get the feeling she's an occult fan. I mean, going off... Oh, there's the accessories! Okay, yeah. Definitely an occult fan. Mm-hmm. I'm Moe Watanabe. Her name is Moe, and I'm sorry, she is decidedly not Moe. Maybe later, but definitely not right now. I'm here to talk to her about this article she wrote in, OO Parts. OOP Arts, Monthly. Which is weird, okay. OOP Arts Monthly, that's what I'm calling it from now on. She pulls out an occult magazine, out of her bag. Inside is a picture of the mark. The accompanying article says the scar is... a soul-inhibiting disease that erases memories. Inquire at Kujo Mansion. This is the same scar, right? Moe lifts her skirt a bit to show me her leg. Right there on her thigh is the mark. I think I know what the article means by erasing memories. I've been super forgetful lately. I'm even blanking on my friends' names. Uh-oh. That's never happened to me before. Do you really think the scar is doing it? Oh god. I cannot do little boy voices. Little boy voices are not my specialty. I will do my best. That article is totally bogus. The young boy scoffs. Even kids know better than to believe in ghosts or curses these days. And a high schooler fell for it. You must feel embarrassed about that. Little boy, you're here too! And you look terrified! I'm pretty sure you also believe it and are very worried you're gonna die! I'm worried you're gonna die! But Tsukasa? Weren't you hanging around out in front of the mansion's gate? Fess up, your scar scares you. Tsukasa seems to have no retort to that. He silently sulks. Looks like a bullseye. It's clear they're both mark bearers. I better bring them over to meet Mary. Okay, now, children, this is Mary. Yeah, that Moe shrieks excitedly when she gets close. That is not the reaction I was expecting, but that is a reaction to have. Oh my god, it's so cute. No! Mary is decidedly not cute. Cool? Interesting? Adorable even, but not cute. It's a doll, yeah? I've never seen one this big. The craftsmanship is so detailed. It's almost like it's alive. They're both admiring her when... Welcome to the Kujo Mansion. What? It spoke! With that, the two new visitors join our number. They entered this monstrous world that hovers on the precipice of death. Mary tells Moe and Tsukasa about the mark once they regain their composure. All about the steady memory loss and their imminent death. Now, it sounds like a ridiculous story, but it gains validity coming from someone like her. Both of their faces pale. Now, if you came specifically here because you believed Lady Saya's article, you must have already experienced the pain of losing your memories. Moe admitted as much earlier, but I can see Tsukasa's face darken. So it must have happened to him, too. Hey, Moe, I'd like to confirm something. Where were you when you got the mark? My amnesia seems to be worse than theirs, so they might remember. I'm not positive, but I think my mark might be a curse from Hanahiko. Hanahiko? What's Hanahiko? Hanahiko?
This name is familiar to me. He is the ghost the resident children of the town whisper about, correct? My master was interested in him.
Oh! So maybe that was the ghost I saw in her room!
So, Sayakujo was curious too. Could it be connected to the marks somehow?
I'd like to hear more about this ghost.
As you wish, Lord Yashiki.
You're getting dark now.
Pardon me. Oh god, I should tell you the rumors of Hanahiko. I'm sorry, I sneezed as I was going on.
Chapter 1, Hanahiko! Well, that's the prologue, I guess.
Oh, did you hear? About that ghost boy all the schools in H City are talking about? Sounds like Hanahiko is back. I heard that he can appear if you peek in a school mirror at night. He'll ask you something. Am I pretty? If you tell him no, you'll be fine, but if you say yes, give me that red stuff then. Oh no. And then he just disappears. But that's not all. Hanahiko hates adults, you know. Heard that if the person he asks is an adult, they'll die. And not just drop dead. Their blood is drained from them? Damn. And next to the corpse is a single rose. A rose dripping with blood. Oh, fuck. That's not good. That's not good at all. Rumors can be easily manipulated. Passing from one person to another, assumptions and errors mix in. But they also hold a hint of truth. Miss Moe, do you know anything else? I think I probably got my mark when I was investigating Hanahiko at the H Elementary School. That has got to be some sort of clue, but, question. Why do young people pursue these things? If you asked me to go ghost hunting, I am sorry, my answer would be a solid fuck no! Cause I don't mess with supernatural shit. Cause, I mean, like, I'm not super spiritual, but, you know, do I believe that the concept of ghosts and things can be true? Yes, I do. I believe that ghosts definitely could exist, and they very possibly do. And that is why, specifically, I don't fuck with that shit. I stay firmly rooted in the natural reality of the world, and I like it that way. I like it that way a lot. I play horror games to pretend like I'm immersing into that stuff, but I am not. Not at all. It's safe this way. I should ask her more about it. Okay, why were you at H Elementary? My big dream is to write about the occult, so I'd love to see a ghost. I'm sure you would. Why do you have binoculars? I mean, to see things at a distance, I get that. And actually, that would help if something was coming down the hallway. That would actually be really nice. Come to think of it, binoculars are really smart to have. Found this article in a magazine mentioning Hanahiko was seen there. I figured that place would be easier to sneak into than a regular school. And it's been closed down.
Oh, shy-ass nest. Okay.
Was Hanahiko there?
Ooh. Okay.
Okay, so I can do it even when there's questions.
I don't think so. But I can't really say for sure. I went to the mirror. Then a shiver suddenly ran down my spine. I got spooked and left.
You didn't even go through with it? And you call yourself an occultist? What's wrong with you? Come on! Grow a backbone, girl! You're supposed to have a bigger... This girl has bigger balls than I do. I would never go into an abandoned school. But she wussed out at the last second, like I would do. You're on my level now, bitch. I don't know why I'm so angry with you, but I am.
When did you notice the mark? I noticed it later in the bath. A strange scar was suddenly on my thigh. It really surprised me. I realized immediately that it had to be what Professor Cujo wrote about. And I think I have a handle on what happened. No way to know for sure about the ghost. But there's no denying she had the mark after returning from H Elementary.
Then maybe...
Tsukasa glances down at his left hand.
Mine might be from Hanahiko, too. I noticed it after I got home from T Elementary.
Huh. That ghost was seen in a lot of schools in H City, right? Maybe he's remembered something. Better ask him some questions, too. T Elementary. I go to school there. You probably never heard of it since it's the top-ranked elementary in, you probably heard of it. I don't know why I said never. Probably heard of it since it's a top-ranked elementary in H City. What should I ask next? When was that? Maybe around sunset?
That was today? You noticed this today?
I was heading home until I realized I forgot something and turned back. Okay, did you see Hanahiko?
No, I didn't get chills or anything either.
Oh, but I think I passed a mirror. I went to the bathroom before going home. Okay, I don't think he knows any more than that. Well, their stories are pretty similar to the Hanahiko rumors, except for they haven't seen anything. Like, a mirror! That's all you've got! I have a mirror in my bathroom! I don't want to go into my bathroom right now! Just realizing, I don't want to go into my bathroom right now. I'm going to hold it. But I do got to end the episode soon because we're at time. So let's see if we can go a little bit further and see if we can finish this up. It can't be a coincidence.
You must investigate the places where Hanahiko appeared. For their sake as well as yours.
Do we have time to do that in a single night? We only have until dawn. I don't know what time it is now. Okay, if we're going by, it's winter time. Because I'm going by winter time, because it's winter right where I am right now. If we're going by winter time, then that means that it's probably like 5 or 6 o'clock. So that means, sunrise is at 7. They've got 11 hours. They've got about 11 hours before dawn. Like, maybe 7:30, 8 o'clock, so maybe 12 hours at most. That's, I'm sorry, that would be 13 hours originally, 14 regularly. Sorry about that. Okay. For their sake as well as yours. No, that's all well and good, but, who exactly am I investigating? Death and life coexisting? If the mark originated there, then a way to erase it will also be there. You must find it. Find the key you need to break the mark's curse. This is the only way to escape. All of a sudden, a huge burden was dropped on my shoulders. It seems that Hanahiko appeared at two schools. Where will you investigate? Let's start with H Elementary, because that's the original school, right? Yeah, that's probably wise. They'd arrest you on spot if you tried to sneak into a regular school. This is true. A middle-aged man who can't recall his name, let alone address or his job title. I'd have no excuses if I got caught. Fuck. Wanna get going then? Let's do this. Oh, wait, you're coming too? Of course. I haven't given up on seeing Hanahiko yet. She grins at me. She's been grinning the whole time. It's been really creepy. Is she really strong or is just blind optimism? She didn't see the dead body, though. If these two had seen the dead body, they'd be freaking out like me. I'm going to. Not you two. Seriously. My life's on the line here. I don't want the reason I die to be because you messed something up.
Well, aren't you a snarky little boy? Nice clothing, but still, you're kind of a jerk.
Yeah, that's pretty bold. Yeah, good thing you're cute. You think that's cute? It's grown on me, but still, no, I don't like this kid yet. But to bring kids along with me, everyone's gonna think I'm a pedophile. I understand your hesitation. Yeah, I have an underage girl. I think she looks like 15, 16. And, you know, a small boy going with you to an abandoned school. This will not look good in any situation, no matter what.
The mark does not discriminate, stealing lives of children and adults. If they wish to fight their fate, you should honor that. I suppose human logic doesn't fly when dealing with the supernatural. We need to prepare ourselves for the worst if we're going to survive. Please take only one mark bearer with you, however. A large group will increase the odds of you being detected by spirits. I also ask that you not waste time dawdling with others on the way. It is possible unnecessary contact. I was reading that weird, sorry. It is possible unnecessary contact may hasten the effects of the mark. Only engage when absolutely necessary. Keep contact with others to a minimum. Have a safe trip. And I think that is where we're going to call it for this first episode. Damn, we're going to be getting on some interesting stuff here. I am super excited to see where this is going to go and like what's going to happen next. Oh my god. Oh, I'm so excited. I haven't played, like, a genuine horror game like this in a while. Which, like, you know, Yomiwari was a great horror game. This is a visual novel horror game, which is a bit different because it's more based on choices and everything. But I am still loving the atmosphere. It is building a great atmosphere. The few voices that they have, like, for the doll, are creepy. And yet they fit so perfectly. And the mystery is building. And what I love more than anything is a good mystery. So I am going to enjoy this in the next episode, along with all of you. So, thank you everybody so much for watching. Appreciate you being here with me. Next time, we're going to go to H school. I'm probably going to take Moe with me, because Moe was at that school. It makes more sense to bring her to this one. And then I want to go to T Elementary to bring the kid. I don't know, like, maybe things will change if I do different routes. And there's probably, like a bad ending and a true ending to this game. And so, I'll see what I can do about getting all those endings. But, either way, we're gonna have some fun. I'm glad that we're starting a new horror adventure, and thank you for coming along with me on this grand new adventure. Thank you again, and until next time, have yourselves a beautiful day, my beautiful, beautiful viewers!